Some of the problems we have with prayer arise out of a wrong understanding of God. The better we know about God in the scriptures, the better we will understand how to pray and why God responds to prayer as He does. So, it is very important that we know the amazing prayer, which is what we should use when we pray to God. So, if you want to know the whole truth about the amazing prayer, please continue watching until the end to find out. And if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon so you never miss an upload. So, let's move on. The amazing prayer that we should use is the Lord's Prayer, which is a common name for the Our Father. The prayer that Christ taught to His disciples when they asked Him how to pray. Luke 11:1-4. The name, the Lord's Prayer, is used more often today by Protestants than by Catholics. But most Christians do not know and understand how to use the Lord's Prayer, which is why the Lord's Prayer is just like an ordinary prayer. But the fact is that the Lord's Prayer, or the Our Father, is the most effective way to pray and the most amazing prayer that God can never refuse if we understand it and apply it in the right way. But most Christians today may not know this, which is why our prayers are never answered by God. The Lord's Prayer is a pattern that Jesus taught His followers to pray. The significance of this prayer is in what the words point us to and remind us of. Through this pattern, Jesus teaches us a balanced prayer life. The Lord's Prayer is a reminder of who God is and how we should engage with Him. Therefore, we should learn and understand the Lord's Prayer, and the best way to understand the Lord's Prayer, the Our Father, is to break it down line by line. Like Our Father, God is our Father because He created humankind, and the Father not only of Jesus Christ but all of us. We pray to Him as Christ's brothers and sisters, who art in heaven. God is in heaven, but that does not mean that He is distant from all of us, because He is everywhere and He is exalted above all of creation. But He is also present throughout creation. Hallowed be Thy name. Hallowed means to make holy. God's name is hallowed or holy above all others. But this is not simply a statement of fact. It's a petition to God the Father. As Christians, we desire that all honor God's name as holy, because acknowledging God's holiness draws us into the right relationship with Him. Thy kingdom come. It is a positive outlook, an intense feeling of supplication that God may reign and change our whole lives according to His very purpose. It is not simply the objective fact that God is our King, but also our acknowledgement of His reign. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. As Christians, we also aim to follow His will on earth as it is in heaven. With these words, we petition God to help us know and carry out His will in this life, and for all mankind to do so as well. Give us this day our daily bread. With these words, we ask God to provide us with everything that we need. Our daily bread is that which is essential for everyday life. But that does not mean simply the food and other goods that keep our physical body alive, but that which nourishes our soul as well. For the Bible says in Matthew 4:4, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. This petition is the most challenging and very important part of the Lord's Prayer, because it requires us to act before God responds. Here, we ask Him to forgive our sins, but only after we have forgiven the sins of others against us. We beg God to show us mercy, not because we deserve it, but rather because we do not. but we must first show mercy toward others, especially when we think that they do not deserve it. And lead us not into temptation. A temptation is a trial that tests our faith and virtue. And to keep us strong when we must face such trials, if we understand and follow what the Lord's Prayer requires, God can never deny what we ask in prayer. And everybody will say Amen. I hope you enjoy watching this video. Please like and comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. God bless you.